Unmute yourself and and next week we will have Sungju Lee from Korea. Yeah, I will just send a link for the schedule. Yeah, that's the plan. Okay, so it's great pleasure to have Yutaka Yoshida from IPMU. He's going to tell us about monopole bulb length rooftop LiDAR in 3-4-5 dimension. Please.
Thank you for the introduction, and also thanks Nabata-san for invitation. In my talk, I focus on monopole bubbling effect and PPS to rooftop operator in 3, 4, and 5 dimension. And these three colors are related to the color of these four paper, not four paper, three paper and one upcoming paper. So in three dimension, with Takuya Okuda, we developed a supersymmetric localization computation of Tofuft operator. In three dimension, Tofuft operator is called monopole operator. And we study the relation between our localization formula and quantized Coulomb branch chiraling by Primo-Artemovsky vibe. And in four dimension, with Hirotaka Hayashi and Takuya Okuda, in the first paper, we study the relation between wall crossing phenomena in monopole bubbling effect and operator product of the Tofuft operators. So monopole bubbling in four dimension is given by a certain Witten index. So Witten index in general have a wall crossing. In the second paper, recent, very recent paper, which was accepting JHEP, we generalize the construction of the monopole bubbling effect to SO and USP theory by introducing an orient hole in plane construction. And recently, I studied the localization computation of the Tofuft surface operator in 5 dimension. And probably I'll submit the paper in near future. First, I explain some introduction. I mean the notation, terminology, and motivation to study these Tofuft operators. So in my talk, I consider following class of gauge theories, a supersymmetric gauge theory with 8 supercharges, and the space-time is M cross R3. If M is point, in this case, space-time is R3, and this class of gauge theory is called 3-dimensional N equal 4 gauge series. And in 4-dimension, we take M is S1, and in this case, a gauge theory is called a 4-dimensional N equal 2 gauge theory. And in 5-dimension, we take M is T2, and this theory is called 5-dimensional N equal 1 gauge theory. The Tofuft operator, later I explain the detailed definition of the Tofuft operator, but the Tofuft operator, roughly speaking, codimension 3 magnetically charged object. So in 3-dimension, this is a point-like object. And usually, this Tofuft operator is called a bare monopole operator in 3-dimensional N equal 4 gauge theory. And in 4-dimension, codimension 3 object is a line or loop-like object. It gives a loop operator. In our case, loop operator wrapping on this S1 direction. And in 5-dimension, in this case, codimension 3 object is a surface operator and extend along T2 direction. And this is give a Tofuft surface operator. The motivations to study these Tofuft operator following. In 3-dimension, first I explain a 3-dimensional case. In 3-dimensional N equal 4 gauge theory, there are, roughly speaking, two types of vacua, one is a Higgs branch vacuum, a moduli space of the Higgs branch vacuum. And it is known that the moduli space of the Higgs branch vacuum does not receive any correction, perturbative or non-perturbative. So once the gauge group and the representation of the Hypermann spectra is given, we know the explicit description of the moduli space in terms of hyperkähler quotient. I mean the intersection of the F term and D term condition divided by global gauge transformation. On the other hand, Coulomb branch vacuum, moduli space of the Coulomb branch vacuum receives perturbative and also non-perturbative correction due to the Tofu-Fitt Polyakov monopole. And probably late 1990s, these corrections to the hyperkähler matrix of the Coulomb branch moduli space was studied. But it is very difficult to determine the exact hyperkähler matrix coming from the non-perturbative correction. Probably this problem is very difficult. But if we forget the hyperkähler structure, and regard this moduli space as an algebraic variety. Then problem is to determine the coordinate ring of the Coulomb branch moduli space after the quantum correction is included. And the coordinate ring in the physical literature is known, called as Coulomb branch chiral ring. This is the algebra of the scalar in the vector multiplet, complex combination of the scalar in the vector multiplet, and the monopole operator. So problem reduced to determine the quantum correction to the monopole operator. This problem is, I think, not easy, still difficult, but easier than to determine the exact hyperkähler. And about six years ago, Brimard de Mortegaio introduced a certain artificial algebra called abelianized Coulomb branch chiral ring in terms of abelianization. Abelianization is a restriction of the gauge group to the maximal torus. And they determine the ring relation of this algebra in terms of 3D abelian mirror. In my talk, I don't explain the how to construct the this abelianized Coulomb branch chiral ring. But one nice feature of the this abelianized Coulomb branch chiral ring is that we know explicit ring relation, and they conjecture that the genuine Coulomb branch chiral ring. By the way, this quantized means that this quantized means that deformation quantization of the Coulomb branch chiral ring. General, a genuine Coulomb branch chiral ring is isomorphic to the subalgebra of this abelianized Coulomb branch chiral ring. So once the identification between the element of the genuine Coulomb branch chiral ring and the element of the abelianized Coulomb branch chiral ring is given, then the ring relation of the genuine Coulomb branch chiral ring follows from the ring relation of the abelianized Coulomb branch chiral ring. They determine that by using this construction, Brimard de Mortegaio determines a Coulomb branch chiral ring of Eddy Kuiper-Gauge theory. Eddy Kuiper-Gauge theory is that for each node for Dynkin diagram, each node corresponds to the unitary gauge. So in this construction, they use a partially use a abelian mirror symmetry. So it is natural to ask that is it possible to derive the Coulomb branch chiral ring directly, for example, using a supersymmetric localization. So far, do you have any question or comments? No. Next, I explain motivation to study Wilson Tofu-Fitt loop in four-dimensional n equal two cells. So Tofu-Fitt loop have attracted attention in the context of AZT conjecture. AZT conjecture is enriched by introducing loop operators. And two groups, RD et al. And Jirukka et al., two groups independently suggest the correspondence of the loop operator and object in the 2D CFD. But in so these two paper appears, when these two paper appears, a bevel of the post operator was not evaluated. Supersymmetric localization formula for a post operator was obtained by Komis Okuda-Peston on space time is S4. And when the space time is S1 cos R3, Ito Okuda-Taki evaluates the expectation. And the precise relation Ito Okuda-Taki found is the following. While we do not transform, this is a while quantization of the bevel of these loop operators. Agree with the fairing bevel operator. This is a certain difference operator acting on conformal block in Euler and Torsen. But there is a subtlety. When the monopole bubbling is absent, in this case is called minuscule case. Magnetic charge minuscule representation. In this case, Ito Okuda-Taki found that the 2D, 4D computation perfectly agree each other. But magnetic, this is monopole. Monopole bubbling effect. In this 2D, 4D computation, have a very similar expression, but slightly different. So one missing term exists in 2D side. And this puzzle is recently, about not recently, about 2 years ago, resolved by Brenner and Eigenwa. I'll explain later. And also algebra of loop operator, I mean the algebra of Wilson loop, Tofuft loop, and Dionic loop, in the presence of omega background have interesting property. It gives a deformation quantization of flat connection on punctured Riemann surface. For example, SU2 gauge, n equal 2 star SU2 gauge theory case, algebra of this operator related to the type A1 spherical Dahas. And you can find the Nawata-san talk on YouTube on these topics. And also, a monopole bubbling effect is only computed in the UN gauge theory, SUN gauge theory, in the previous works, I mean the Ito Okuda-Taki or Brenner and Eigenwa. Before our work, to the best of my knowledge, monopole bubbling effect for SO and USP gauge theory were not known. In my talk, I briefly explain the construction of the monopole bubbling effect for SO2N gauge theory. And in five dimension, a BPS Tofuft surface operator, existence of such surface operator was implied in several works, but I think no one have explicitly computed the bevel of such surface operators. And in four dimension, deformation quantization of the Tofuft operator, I mean the wild Wigner transform, sometimes related to the interesting difference operators of trigonometric type. I mean the coefficient is given by trigonometric function. A typical example is McDonald operators. A trigonometric McDonald operator arises from the deformation quantization of the certain Tofuft operator in 4D n equal 2 star gauge theory. So it is natural to expect a five-dimensional uplift of the Tofuft loop operator to the Tofuft surface operator, give an elliptic deformation of the McDonald operator and its cousins. Actually, our localization formula gives an elliptic Luisner operator. I'll briefly mention the last slide. So these are motivation to study Tofuft operator in 3, 4, and 5 dimensions. Next, I explain the definition of the BPS Tofuft operators. A BPS Tofuft operator is defined by path integral with certain boundary condition. Here, B express a magnetic charge of the top of the loop. This is a covariant of gauge group, B algebra of gauge group. And this B is a boundary condition, I'll explain. And here A is a gauge field. And sigma is a adjoint scalar in the vector map. And dot dot means a represent the other field in the vector and hypermanifold. And this is action. In my talk, I don't explain the detail of other boundary condition for other field. We concentrate on the gauge field and scalar in the vector. And we have to specify the three types of boundary condition. One is the boundary condition near the center of Dirac monopole, which characterizes the magnetic charge. And we also have to specify the boundary condition at the spatial infinity of R3. R3 is this R3. And in general, by imposing a twist boundary condition along M, M is S1 or T2, we can introduce one omega background parameter, which gives a deformation quantization of the algebra of the TOEFL. So boundary condition near the center of Dirac monopole is following. We impose the following boundary condition. So a coordinate of the gauge field and scalar in the vector punishment approach to the point in R3. Then field strengths behave as have a monopole solution. And BPS condition requires that the scalar behave as this. Here P is a wild permutation, wild group of wild group action of B, and B is a coet of Z. So and this B is characterized a charge of TOEFL operators. And next we have to specify the boundary condition at the infinity of R3. And we impose the same type of boundary condition, but here, this is a boundary value of scalar in the vector multiplet at infinity. And we assume that this sigma bar is a Cartan valued constant. Naively, this magnetic charge at the infinity is same as a magnetic charge at the origin, but this, if we take the P is the same as the origin, then a localization computation does not reproduce the correct answer. We have to take into account of the magnetic charge, which is smaller than the magnetic charge measured at the origin. And this effect is called monopole bubbling, or sometimes called a monopole screen, which was originally observed by Kapustin in the context of SDRT between Wilson, OP of Wilson loop and OP of TOEFL loop. And the contribution of the monopole bubbling in the bevel of TOEFL operator was studied by Gomis of Budapesta and Ito of Budapesta. The intuitive picture of this monopole bubbling is following. So when TOEFL Polyakov monopole, TOEFL Polyakov charge of the TOEFL Polyakov monopole is in the this Hurwitz lattice of the real algebra of gauge group. When TOEFL Polyakov monopole surrounds a singular monopole with magnetic charge B, or its permutation, then TOEFL Polyakov monopole screens the magnetic charge of the original Dirac monopole and reduces its value to P, whose absolute value is smaller than original magnetic. マグネティックチャージ、メジャーだった、コアオブイラクモノポール。So this is a monopole bubble. And modular space of a singular monopole, with this monopole bubble, contributes a passive integral. We have to evaluate this modular space contribution in some way. The last part is a sort of boundary condition around them. So one can introduce a twist parameter without breaking at least one supercharge, which is necessary to perform a supersymmetric localization. Here we impose this type of twist boundary condition. Here X is any field in the vector or hypermultiplet. And T is a coordinate in the time circle in N. So, M is N. M is P2. We have 2S1. And this T is one of the coordinates along the time circle. And here, J3 is a generator of U1 R symmetry in the SU2 R symmetry group. Here, this SU2 H R symmetry acton, non-trivial acton hypermultiplet scalar. And J3 is a generator of rotation around S1 direction, X3 axis. And this combination commit with supercharge, so we can introduce this combination without breaking supersymmetry. And in general, we can also introduce a flavor fugacity. This is FF is a F small f is a generator of the maximal torus of the flavor symmetry group. And small mf is a fugacity for discharge, which is essentially same as a mass parameter. So we impose these three types of boundary condition and perform the supersymmetric localization computation. The supersymmetric localization computation was originally done by Ito Kurataki. This is very interesting paper. And we add the one parameter family of the Q-exact term and take the weak coupling. Then after very complicated computation, we obtain this expression. Here M is a flavor fugacity and epsilon is a omega background parameter, as I said. And we have to perform summation over the possible monopole bubble sectors. And here A is a holomorphic combination of the gauge field along with M. And the M is D2 case. D2 case. A is some combination of the gauge field along the T2 direction. And when M is S1, in this case, we perform the dimensional reduction along this direction. So A becomes a combination of the scalar and the gauge field along S1 direction. When M is point, A is nothing but the complex scalar in the vector matrix, is a complex scalar. In vector matrix. And B is a proportional to a bevel of another scalar, which is fixed by a boundary value at the spatial infinity. And more precisely, there is some multiplicative constant, which is not exponential. So localization formula, as I said first, we have to summation over the possible topological sector, including the monopole bubbling effect. And this part is a saddle point value of the supersymmetric and boundary term labeled by this field configuration. So this field configuration is a zero locus of the QF graph, becomes zero locus of the QF graph term. And we substitute this value to the superabilities action. And the boundary term to regularize the divergence coming from the center of the monopole. Then this gives the P times. Here, dot express the inner product of P and P. And the one loop part is a one loop determinant. This is a one loop determinant around the field configuration labeled by this one. And this computation with one loop determinant is very complicated, but the computation is quite parallel to the computation by Torque.k. And we obtain this expression. Here, alpha is a coroute, possible coroute. And, So one loop determinant factorizes the one loop determinant of vector multiplet and hyper multiplet. And one loop determinant of the vector multiplet is given by this function. Here, product is over the possible root. And one loop determinant of the hyper multiplet is given by these functions. Here, R means the representation, the weight of the representation of the chiral multiplet inside the hyper multiplet. And by using a certain index theorem for transversal elliptic operator, we obtain this expression. And here, F is depend on the space time. So in three dimensions, this is Fx is just a x. And S1 cross R3 case, Kaltz-Klein mode along S1 direction, deform this function to the trigonometric function. And T2 cross R3 case, KK mode along T2 direction, deform this function x to the elliptic function. Here, theta 1 is the Jacobi theta function. And this in three dimension, we obtain this formula, and we should mention some related work by Assel, Cremonas, and Vick. They independently obtain the same formula, and we did a coordinate submission. A last part is a monopole bubbling effect, which is the most subtle point. This part is interpreted as a path integral over the moduli space of a singular monopole with monopole bubbling effect labeled by this. And this part is interpreted as a moduli space. Over the singular monopole, so with and monopole bubbling means when x is x zero and if a is p, x go to infinity with absolute value of the p is smaller than original magnitude. And this part is interpreted as a integral over this moduli space of something. Originally, this contribution, monopole bubbling effect, is evaluated by using Kronheimer correspondence, which is a correspondence between a moduli space of a singular monopole, I mean, this moduli space, And S1 equivalent, modular space of S1 equivalent instant on turbulent space. So S1 equivalent, modular space of instant on turbulent space cover natural S1 action associated with turbulent circle. And it occurred that the conjecture that this Z mono is given by a certain projection of the Nicholas of partition function. But as I said, this computation does not reproduce the Fehring operator. So about 2 years ago, important point is about 2 years ago, Brennan and Deneva proposed another construction that this monopole bubbling effect in terms of D-Brenn construction. And they conjecture that the monopole bubbling effect is given by the width index of the world, low energy world volume theory on D1 Brenn. And as I mentioned, so this width index is evaluated at the FI, zero FI parameter region. In this case, there is additional contribution to the width index coming from 1D Coulomb Grand state. So width index in general is index is a sum of the Higgs branch state. Branch state. A plus Coulomb branch state. And this Higgs branch state is this Coulomb Higgs branch state agree with the projection of the Nicholas of partition function. So in the original computation by Ito Kurataki, they miss the Coulomb branch state. So by including this Coulomb branch state contribution, Brennan and Deneva reproduce a Fehring loop operator from the cage theory side. This is a resolution of the puzzle. So far, do you have any question? So before I explain the
Yes, could you say a little more about this projection?
Mm-hmm. Of the projection.
Function? What do they do exactly? Do you know?
So I don't remember the precise form, but this projection, so projection is associated with the S1 action mm-hmm. of the coordinate. So this projection is translated into the certain shift of omega background parameter. Shift or something.
Mm-hmm.
And their conjecture is they extract the invariant part under the this shift mm-hmm. in the Nicholas of partition function.
Mm-hmm.
It gives a monopole bubbling effect. And they also studied some correspondence in the level of modular space.
Mm-hmm. I see. Thank you.
But does it capture this Coulomb branch states?
No, this only captures the Higgs branch state.
I see.
So roughly speaking, the Nicholas of formula only capture k-theoretic Nicholas of partition function only capture the Higgs branch state of ADHM quantum mechanics.
I see.
And in general, there is additional contribution from the 1D Coulomb branch state.
Okay, thanks.
So before I explain Brenn construction of the monopole bubbling effect, here I show one simple example, which is determined by one loop contribution. I consider three-dimensional n equal 4 SQED. This means a gauge group is U1. And NF flavor means that there are NF charge plus one hypermal. So in this case, a magnetic charge is just an integer, a coweight of U-binds, integer. And localization formula obtained by with Okuda is general expressions returns this. So in this case, we do not have a monopole bubbling effect. And the summation does not appear. And we introduce the product of the monopole, in this case, this is the monopole operator, by the Moyal product. The definition of the Moyal product for U1 theory is given by this. Then the direct computation shows that the monopole operator with higher charge is generated by product Moyal product of the monopole operator with smallest charge. And product Moyal product of the monopole operator with opposite charge give a certain combination of scalar in the vector multiplet, complex scalar in the vector multiplet and omega background parameter and mass parameter and so on. And we take the Weyl-Wigner transformation. Here I didn't write the definition of the Weyl-Wigner transformation. But here I put the hat to express the Weyl-Wigner transform. Then Weyl-Wigner transform give this expression. And these relations are precisely same as the deformation quantization of the Coulomb branch curving for NF Clever SQD. So it agrees with the result by Brimard-Mostevayo for Abelian gauge theory. And if we take the turn of the omega background parameter, then the Moyal product reduces to the ordinary commutative product. And then the relation reduces to the two types of relation. So the Coulomb branch chirality is the algebra monopole operator and scalar divided by this relation is same as this quotient of polynomial. And this is nothing but a coordinate, this is nothing but a coordinate ring of deformation of the T2 over the N and mass parameter deform the singularity. If we turn off the mass parameter, this equation is same as. This is a C2 over a ZNF. And in similar manner, we show that the algebra monopole operator and scalar reproduce a quantized Coulomb branch chirality for type A Cuiber gauge theory by Brimard-Mostevayo and ADHM Cuiber gauge theory by Braverman-Finkelberg. So in these two class of gauge theory and the type A Cuiber and ADHM Cuiber, a gauge group is both of the gauge group are unitary groups. And in this case, in this case, generator of the Coulomb branch chirality, monopole operator, monopole operator entering the generator of the Coulomb branch chirality does not have a monopole bubbling effect. So it's easy to show the correspondence identification between our localization formula and formula by Braverman-Finkelberg Nakajima and Brimard-Mostevayo. But if the generator contains a monopole bubbling effect, I'm not sure our results agree with the result by a mathematician or previous result. So this is a three-dimensional result. And next, I explain the monopole bubble construction of the monopole bubble effect in terms of plane construction. So this is a brain configuration for monopole babbling. This part is responsible for four-dimensional theory. I mean the world volume theory on D4 brain give a unitary vector map, UN vector map, or SUN vector. And if we introduce the D6 brain, which gives a hypermask in the fundamental representation. And here I consider four-dimensional case. Two-dimensional and five-dimensional case is a parallel. Because if we take the TDR along zero direction, then this configuration gives a monopole bubbling in three dimensions. On the other hand, if we take a TDR along x5 direction, then this brain configuration gives a monopole bubbling effect on D2 cross Rc. And this x5 direction is also a compactified in five dimensions. By the way, my brain configuration is slightly different from the original brain configuration by Brain and Imua. They consider in the type 2B picture. And in this paper, we consider type 2A picture. And here I write the brain configuration used in paper. And if we introduce the orient hole, then depending on the type of orient hole, we obtain the SO2N gauge group or SO2N plus one or a unitary simplex group. And to describe the Tofuft operator or Tofuft Polyakov monopole, we introduce a semi-infinite D2 brain. And later we terminate this D2 brain on as another type of NS5 brain. And here I put a dash to distinguish this NS5 brain from the NS5 brain responsible for four-dimensional gauge theory. And correspondence between magnetic charge and brain configuration following. So in my convention, a D2 brain ended on D4 brain from the right hand side. It corresponds to the magnetic charge 10000, and correspondence between monopole or Tofuft operator and brain configuration was studied Hanani and Diakonesk and probably many people. And recently, as I said, brain and brain were considered brain construction. On the other hand, if D2 brain ended on D4 brain from the left hand side, this brain configuration corresponds to the magnetic charge 0000. And minus. And this is an example of another type of brain configuration. If KD2 brain ended on K stack of D4 brain in a different position, this D2 stack of D2 brain corresponds to the magnetic charge 1111 and 000. And the important step to construct a monopole bubbling, we terminate this semi-infinite brain, semi-infinite D2 brain on the NS5 prime brain to lead off the world volume of D2 brain. And this is a configuration example of the configuration of the Tofuft operator. Here, as I said, D2 brain ended on D4 brain from the right, corresponds to magnetic charge 1000. And D2 brain ended on D4 brain from the right hand side, corresponds to the magnetic charge 000-1. So the total system have a magnetic charge 000. So total configuration, this whole configuration corresponds to the TOFUF operator with this magnetic charge. So to describe the monopole bubbling effect, we introduce a D2 plane suspended between a D4 plane. And this D2 plane corresponds to a TOFUF to Polyakov monopole with magnetic charge 1000 plus 1. Then the total sum of the original magnetic charge and magnetic charge of the TOFUF to Polyakov monopole becomes 0. Then monopole bubbling effect occurs. And actually, if three segments of these two brains coincide, then the single D2 brain are created, formed. Then this configuration does not any magnetic charge. This is a brain picture of the monopole bubbling. And the conjecture by Brillouin de Moffette, Brennan de Moivre, is a monopole bubbling effect in the TOFUF loop is given by Witten index of world volume theory on D2 brain. And from this brain configuration, we can read off the matter content of the, this supersymmetric quantum mechanics. For example, open string between D2, D2, D2 brain gives a dimensional reaction of the 0,4 U1 vector multiplied to one dimension. So in this case, we have a single D2 brain. So gauge group or gauge of quantum mechanics is U1. And open string connected between D4 and D2 brain gives a dimensional reaction of the 0,4 hyper multiplied to one dimension. And this number of 0,4 hypermultiplet are same as the number of D4 planes. The last part is the open string connected between D6 and D2 plane, which gives a short Feynman multiplet. So the world volume theory on D2 plane is specified by a disk Kuiper diagram. So gauge group is U1. And there are n 0,4 hypermultiplet, and n, there are n 0,4 short Feynman multiplet. And by using the localization formula, we can compute the Witten index in the non-negative FI parameter, non-zero FI parameter region. So far, do you have any question? And the property of the Witten index is following. In general,
Hello, Yoshida.
Hello.
I have a question going back to the case where you presented the equations, the deformed equation for C2 mod Zn.
Yes. This one?
Yeah, so here you presented equations which are for moduli space, which is a complete intersection, a hyper
subgroup. Yes, yes.
And most moduli spaces are not like that. So do you know what to do when you have such a case that yeah, it's more like this. It's like U2 with n flavors. So this will be still a complete intersection, but
it depends. Complete intersection will not depend on the number of flavor, right? But or agree or not theory.
Sorry. Most
most modular spaces are not complete intersections. That's why I'm just wondering, what will you do in the case? So you need to have many more equations.
Mm-hmm.
And these equations that you have in the blue square that you have here.
So in non-abelian case, we also have a Dressel monopole operator.
Mm-hmm.
And there are relation not only the relation between scalar and bare monopole operator, but we also have a relation between a scalar and bare monopole operator and also Dressel monopole operator. Is it related to your answer? Question for your answer?
No. Take modular spaces of, let's say you take one of the ADE quivers and you compute the Coulomb branch. So the Coulomb branch is going to be some minimal nilpotent orbit. And a minimal nilpotent orbit is not a complete intersection. It's very rare that it would be. There's only one such case. So then the question is, how would you write the equations?
You mean how do I write the ring relation?
Yes.
So actually, Brillouin Dimorte guy write down the generator and its relation. And we admit their results and compare the algebra of monopole operator and algebra of scalar and monopole operator obtained by localization formula. And we compare the our result and Brillouin-Dimorte-Gault result. So actually, I didn't write the link relation for Kuiper-Gauss theory explicitly.
I see. Okay. Just it's going to be a problem in general.
And thank you for comment.
Can you in principle write down the relation for any 3D n equal to 4?
In general, probably.
Yeah, of course. I mean, it's and practically it's very difficult, I would imagine. But can you, in principle, write down the relation?
I would say yes.
I see. As far as remember, this Tudor and then Matt and then Davide's paper give prescription in principle. I would imagine. As far as I remember. Of course, in practice, it's very difficult, I guess.
So if you're dealing with a nilpotent orbit, you just write down the relations for any nilpotent orbit, but there'll be plenty of them, and certainly not a complete intersection.
Uh-huh.
And if you have slices in the affine Grassmannian, then again you could you'll have to work harder.
Mm-hmm.
But you could write down the relations. I just don't know how to generalize the formations. Will be another challenge, right? Because was not the relation, it was also the formations.
Yeah.
And it's just not been done. Each time people present examples, they do it for the Coulomb branch of U1 with n flavors. And it's possible that that's the only result.
Yeah, I see.
So, so the question is, what can be done in such a case? It's not representing. U1 with n flavors is not representing the difficulty that you have.
Yes. I agree. Okay, thank you very much. Maybe go ahead for your talk.
How much time is remaining?
I think, I mean,
4 minutes?
No, Baba, go ahead. I have, we are flexible about time. But I need to catch a train in 1 hour. So I have to leave it in 1 hour. So at least you have 1 hour.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
So a proposal by Evren and Emuiza, monopole bubbling effect is given by a world volume theory on V2 brain suspended between NS5 prime. And I briefly explain the, some general property of the Witten index. So Witten index is in general have a discontinuous change from the FI parameter across a codimension one wall in the space of the FI parameter. This is nothing but a wall crossing phenomenon. And if the FI parameter in the at a generic point, I mean the generic point in the phase, for example, in the geometric phase or around the wind phase, Witten index is evaluated by a certain multi-quantile integral called Jeffrey-Kawa residue prescription. This was extensively, intensively studied by Horikimi. But if a FI parameter is not at the generic point, it's on a codimension one wall, then the additional contribution to the Witten index appears. This is, as I said, a 1D Coulomb branch state, or in general, a mixed branch state also contribute to the Witten index. So, but so far, physical interpretation of this wall crossing phenomena. Wall crossing phenomena is a phenomena in the 1D quantum mechanics, not a 4D physics. So what is a wall crossing phenomena? Is a monopole bubbling effect. Means in the bevel of Tofu's operators. So this is a result of our first paper. Then wall crossing phenomena related to the different ordering of the Moyard product or different type ordering of the operator product in the correlation function. For example, two-point functions, two Tofu operator are related to the, agree with the same as the Moyard product of the two different ordering. Here, X31 is a X3 coordinate of the Tofu operator TB1. And X32 is a X3 coordinate of the Tofu operator TB2. Then one can, in simple gauge theory, one can, Ito Kurataki show that if X3 coordinate of the this Tofu operator is larger than the X3 coordinate of the Tofu operator TB2, this correlation function is same as the Tofu operators. If X3 coordinate of the Tofu operator TB1 is smaller than X3 coordinate of the TB2, then 2-point function is same as the Moyard product of the different order. And in general, Moyard product is non-commutative, and these two expressions are different, give a different values. And I show some one example here. We consider a monopole bubbling effect in the previous example. specified by this prepath. And in the positive FI parameter region, this is a generic point in the phase. Then the Witten index, I mean the monopole bubbling effect, is evaluated by using Jeffrey-Cowan region. In this case, Jeffrey-Cowan region is just a usual radiative. And the Jeffrey-Cowan prescription tells us that when the FI parameter is positive, radiative is evaluated at this point. So denominator also contains a pole at a negative sign, but we do not evaluate the radiative at this negative sign point. And it's easy to evaluate this compound integral and give this result. And in the brain picture, a positive FI parameter region corresponds to a displacement of the 2D2 brain in this region. And the negative FI parameter region, on the other hand, Jeffrey-Cowan residue is evaluated at the pole with negative sign. So previous case, this part is plus region. And again, it's easy to compute this expression. And in general, Witten index or monopole bubbling effect evaluated in the positive FI parameter region and the negative FI parameter region is different. And brain picture, in the brain picture, a negative FI parameter region corresponds to the, this displacement. In the previous case, the positive FI parameter region corresponds to the, this displacement. Then relation between a monopole bubbling effect and a Moyer product are following. So in the, this is the expectation value of the Tofuft operator, where monopole bubbling effect is evaluated in the positive FI parameter region. Agree with the Moyer product of the Tofuft operators with minimal charges. So this side does not have a monopole bubbling effect, and we know the explicit form of the wave by the one loop computation and the Itoku-Dataki. And the direct computation of the Moyer product shows that this Moyer product is the same as the wave of Tofuft operator with positive FI parameter. And as I said, this correspond to a two-point function. Here x1 is larger than x. And this equality have a natural interpretation in terms of brain picture. So positive, this region corresponds to the positive FI parameter region. And the ordering of operator of the Tofuft operator is written as this. So this picture perfectly agrees with this relation. On the other hand, a monopole wave of the Tofuft operator, where monopole bubbling effect is evaluated in the negative FI parameter region, agree with a different ordering of the Moyer product. And this Moyer product and again this ordering have a natural interpretation in terms of brain computation. So each segment of the D2 brain correspond to the Tofuft operator with minimal charges. And X3 is the coordinate along this direction. And this ordering perfectly agrees with this configuration. And we did a more complicated computation, is a more complicated example. I mean the magnetic charge specified by 2000 minus 1. But for simplicity, I consider into this. So in this case, there are one monopole bubbling sector. This is essentially essential thing. By the certain reparametrization of the parameter, is the same. And this left here is a monopole grain configuration for the Tofu's operator with magnetic charge 2-1. So this part corresponds to 1-0, 1-0, and minus 0-1. And to describe the monopole bubbling effect, we introduce a D2 grain suspended between a D4 grain. Then the Hanani Witten transition, we obtain final configuration is given by this. And from this configuration, we can read off the word volume theory on D2 grain. In this case, for simplicity, I consider D4 grain. D6 grain. So, Kuiper quantum mechanics is specified by this Kuiper, and this part corresponds to the number of D6 grain, and this segment corresponds to the U1 vector multiplet, and this segment corresponds to this U1 vector multiplet. So we, in this case, space of FI parameter is more complicated because we have two FI parameters. So module space of the FI parameter is becomes two dimensional. So this is the relation between the FI parameter and ordering of Tofu's operator. And this is a space of FI parameter. So there are six regions, six different regions, possibly different regions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But the actual computation shows that at this wall, wall crossing phenomena does not occur. So this region is the same, give a same monopole bubbling effect. And this region is the same monopole bubbling effect. And these regions give the same monopole bubbling effect. And we compute the various type of Moyard product and compare them with the monopole Tofu's operator, where the monopole bubbling effect is evaluated in the various FI parameters. Then, a different type of Moyard product is essentially three because these two are same operator ordering. And these two are same. So there are three types of different Moyard product. And these three Moyard product perfectly agree with the monopole bubbling effect for T2, for T magnetic charge 2-1. And we have perfect agreement between three different ordering of Moyard product and wall crossing phenomena. This is a result of first paper. But I should mention the SUN gauge theory. So in the SUN gauge theory, minimal magnetic charge is 1-0-0-1, 1-0-0-0 does not exist. So this means that Tofu's operator with this magnetic charge cannot be decomposed product of two tofu operator with smaller magnetic charge. I mean the 1000 or 000 minus one. So in this, in the brain picture, this means the x coordinate of the two segment of the deep brain, this part and this part, have same x3 coordinate. And from the 1D quantum mechanics viewpoint, this point corresponds to the zero FI parameter region. So this is a on the wall of this is one dimension, codimension one wall. So in this case, additional 1D Coulomb branch state contributes the width index. And the Higgs branch state captured by projection of the Nicolaus formula or given by Jeffrey Cowan review. Plus this additional Coulomb branch state reproduces a pairing the loop in the review. So, this is a result by Brennan. So they consider the zero FI parameter region and compute the additional Coulomb branch state by using Born-Oppenheimer approximation. So this is a difference between unitary or and difference between unitary gauge theory and special unitary gauge theories. And I extend that is construction to SO and USB gauge theory in the second paper with Hayashi and Tokuda. Here I consider O4 minus plane. If we change the O4 minus plane to O4 plus plane, then this part becomes unitary simple electric field. So for example, we consider a Tofuft operator with magnetic charge 20000 in SO2N gauge theory. And Tofuft operator with this charge is given by light brain computation. So each segment of the digital brain corresponds to 1000 and 1000. So total system becomes 2000. And in this case, there are two monopole bubbling sector. So one is 11000 and the second is 000. This monopole bubbling effect is obtained by introducing this deep brain. Then the Hanani-Witten transition. Hanani-Witten transition. We obtain this left brain configuration. And the world volume on deep brain does not have an effect of the O brain. So this is just given by the open string between D2, D2, and D4, D2 brains. And this is a Cleaver diagram for quantum mechanics. On the other hand, a monopole bubbling effect specified by this magnetic charge is achieved by introducing this deep brain, these two deep brain. Then after Hanani-Witten transition, we obtain this brain configuration. So this part is same as a previous case, I mean this part. But these two segments of the D2 brain ended on O plane. So this gives a unitary symplectic group. Here, n over 2 expresses n half hypermatrix. And we evaluate, we can evaluate the monopole bubbling effect by using the localization formula in the non-negative, non-zero FI parameter. And in this case, we evaluate the monopole bubbling effect in various chamber of FI parameter And we observe that a wall crossing phenomena does not occur if it implies additional Coulomb transitive does not exist. And we did many consistency check of our computation. First one is the algebra of operator. I mean the operator, Moyal product of the Tohoft operator with smaller charge generates a wave of Tohoft operator with a larger magnetic charge. And we did a similar computation in many examples. In the SO2N, SO2N plus one and unitary symplectic group. And also N equal two star gate theory. And there is another consistency of our result. We compare the Tohoft operator, which have locally isomorphic gauge group. So I see you for. And we so this part have a monopole bubbling effect constructed from a brain configuration with oriented home. On the other hand, left hand side is a monopole bubbling effect for this Tohoft operator is constructed by brain configuration without oriented home. So equality between these two operators highly non-trivial, and we also compute the other type of Tohoft operator, for example, SU2 plus SU2, and so forth. And several in the several magnetic charge, we have an agreement. And the last one is last constitution is SDRT between Wilson loop and Tohoft loop in the four-dimensional Enco four gauge theory with Lagrange dual gauge group. So in the four-dimensional Enco four gauge theory, one loop determinant becomes trivial, and Tohoft loop reduced to a certain character. So in this case, Tohoft loop is a character of G-check. We explicitly compute the wave of Tohoft operator in four-dimensional four gauge theory and check the this reduced to the character of G-check, which is same as the Wilson loop in G-check for the N equal four theory.
Yukata.
Yes.
I was just looking at all the calculation. I think we showed that too.
Oh, you show in
yeah.
Paper, could you tell me?
Oh, with domain 12.
You mean that super conformal index with line operator?
Yeah, there we do SPSO.
I see, but I think in your paper you only consider the Tohoft operator for SUN gauge cell you consider Tohoft operator with monopole bubbling, but USP and SO gauge cell did you consider the Tohoft operator with monopole bubbling effect?
Maybe not.
Yeah, this is a new point of our results, probably.
Oh, okay. Without monopole bubbling, of course, we showed that's true. Right.
Thank you for comment.
Yeah, thank you for your comment. Yeah, I will take a look at it.
Okuda-san, I didn't know this. So, this is the last slide.
By the way, I have a question.
Yes.
Do you have cross form expression for monopole, this partition monopole bubbling formula?
In general, it's very difficult.
Yeah, that's what I would imagine.
So even for SU2 gauge theory, in this case, Brain and them are explicitly write down the Cuiva. Yes. But
the performing JK residue is
hopeless difficult.
So what you did is some power expansion to check the equality.
In many cases, so we restrict we consider several small magnetic charges. So in this case, rank of the JK residue is small. For example, rank one quantum mechanics or rank two quantum. And in many such example, we did the exact computation.
I see.
But higher charge case, rank of the JK radio also become higher rank. In that case, JK radio computation is hopelessly difficult.
I see. Okay, thank you very much.
I have a question going back to the quivers that you presented.
This one? Previous one?
Yes, well, that's one of them. There was also one where you had three NS five rings.
This one?
Yeah. So if we follow the work of Kraft and Pochesi, they tell us that you have a classification of all possible such types using affine Dynkin diagrams and also the, what you showed before. So there was a case before where you showed the U1 with n flavors coupled to some Fermi multiplets, right? In the previous case, if you go further back, there would be another quiver like that.
This one?
This one.
Yes.
Right, so that's U1 with n flavors with some Fermi multiplets, right?
Yes.
And this would be part of the quivers that are proposed by the work of Kraft and Pochesi. I'm just wondering if you consider all of them. For example, if you take affine E diagram, I guess that and affine D, right? Affine D would be also part of this. So what we can, if you go to the case with three NS brains, then that's the we can think of it as affine A2.
Yes.
Okay. And if you look at the SO cases that you had, there is an SO SP1 theory with the N flavors. So all of this is perfect. Those are the cases that are proposed by, that could be inferred from the work of Kraft and Pochesi. I'm wondering if you encounter cases where you have affine D and affine E.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Could you give us the spell of the authors?
Yeah, I didn't know that paper.
Spelling of the authors?
Yeah.
Could you write them down in chat?
Yeah.
Well, we have a paper which explains this. You don't have to go to the original paper, but it's a fun paper to read.
Okay. But which paper is it? Oh, here. Okay. Oh, Kraft and Porch. Okay. Thank you.
I checked our paper. We took care of monopole bubbling, and we checked the SDL between SO and SPA.
really?
Yep, 12.01. We did spinometers and a few cases, so many you can get it later.
Yeah, I look at the data.
Okay, we will compare. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thank you for comment.
So Okuda-san, it's what you will get. So the Kaufman-Pochesi are representation theorists. So they mm-hmm. will not talk about brains, and they will not talk about monopole bubbling for sure. What you will find them is a classification of all possible singularities which can arise. From this, you could infer the types of quivers that you could get. And indeed, this is what you got, right? You got the case of U1 with n flavors, you got the case of affine A2, which could be extended to affine AN if you have many NS brains instead of three, right? But I guess for you, it will be a lot of work because you'll have to consider all of those chambers, the Weyl chambers, because I saw that you had different contributions. So I guess to do the affine A3 would be quite hard.
Mm.
Yeah, I think our motivation was to study line operators, not to study the geometry of the modular space. But I think we should compare. Yeah, we should take a look.
Okay. Well, maybe I shouldn't take too much time. Thank you.
Yes, thank you for coming. Here is the Apple Pencil. Apple Pencil is good. Anyway, this is a result in five dimension. I briefly mentioned. So we evaluate the bevel to surface operator in five dimension n equal one star theory, and we perform the Weyl-Wigner transformation. So this differential operator is a Weyl transformation of the scalar B. And this expression is the same as the elliptic Leusner operator. And the commutativity of the mutual commutativity of these operator is related to the absence of the wall crossing phenomena in the monopole bubbling effect. In this case, monopole bubbling effect is given by elliptic genus. And it is known that the elliptic genus does not depend on the choice of FI parameter and does not depend on the chamber. So situation is different from the mid-day index case. So we consider the elliptic deformation of the Hooft loop operator. But there is one problem. So far, we do not know the elliptic analog of Wilson loop or dionic group. In three-dimensional case, dionic group is called Dolls monopole operator. This is an open problem. And we summarize our result. I find the Apple Pencil. So in three dimension, we have evaluated the bevel of monopole operator and gave a identification with between the localization formula and Abelianized Coulomb branch chirality in some gauge series. And we generalize the brain construction of the monopole bubbling effect to SO and USP gauge theory. And we did several consistency check of our result. And in particular, four-dimensional n equal four gauge theory case, we checked the SDRT between Wilson loop and the Hooft operator in terms of localization formula developed by Ito Kurataki with a monopole bubbling effect developed by us. So in five dimension, we introduce a Hooft surface operator by imposing a certain boundary condition. And evaluate its wave in terms of supersymmetric localization. And for five-dimensional n equal one star PSU two gauge, PSU n gauge theory, a while being a transformed for fixed surface operator, agree with the elliptic Lewisian operators. So this is all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much. Questions from audience?
Yeah, one of thing about this monoprobablings, is you studied like N and M bar of SUN or UN, with one string coming in, then another string leaving. Right, so without say these explains, the moduli space has been known more than 25 years.
So T star, it's not
that simple.
Mm-hmm.
It's a bunch of massive monopoles moving around, and especially interesting case is that when all the D4 brains on top of each other, then it becomes they all become massless.
Mm-hmm.
And if two operators in different place, then it's called the Calabi space. And if they are all massive, then it's called the Lee Weinberg E solution, which is Pidgin A Weinberg in myself. So we studied a lot of bubbling before, word bubbling is there during 96, 97. And we have a lot of information about this. And I'm thinking about those from the recent works by Amihai and also you guys. Mm.
So did you evaluate the width index on word volume theory on Bibli?
Some of them, yes, especially Calabi-Yau case, Calabi case, not Calabi-Yau, where all the deep four brains are on top of each other without these six brains, and then you turn on FI terms, so these two foot operators and finite separation. Then there's only one normalizable middle form. And that's related to a lot of physics, non-commutative instantons, single instantons in UN theories. And the explicit form of the wave function is even found by us many years ago.
Yeah, I think so. In our story, we only consider the special points on the moduli space, which contribute to the localization calculation.
Right, so when they are massless, I guess if you don't turn on the electric charge, then this L2 normalized form is what is interesting. If they are all massive, then of course, two-foot operator will count some threshold bound state. And I guess, I don't know the answer, but anyway, so I see the from message, yes, we consider the non-minuscule SOSP, even we, I think we studied spinners of SP. SO7 spinner is related to SU, SP6 fundamental or something.
No, I think Kimion is answering to my question,
right?
Which asked Kimion
privately, sorry.
Privately.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, but my question was about this super conformal index paper.
About
line operator
with the domain.
Oh, there's another one, line operator index.
Yes, Gankoli paper by Gankoli.
Line operator paper. We wrote two papers, one on the
domain world.
Oh, maybe. So let me see. Right. So there. That's SU2, yes. But if you look at another one, I mean, on the line operator, there we did a lot more.
Which paper is that?
Just before that, so 1201-55-39. So we do SPS2, page 22. Spinor's fundamentals. Right, so for example, page 24, we do Spinor's lesson 7.
Sorry, which paper?
Paper 1, 5, 5.
Write it, type it down. Could you type it in chat?
So line operator index on S1 close to R.
Yeah, but that's... that.
We have...
yes. Do you have what, Spinor?
Yep, page 24. So SO7 reasonable operator and SP6 top operator, they match.
Oh, 20
page 24.
With more. So, here, did you use the ADHM construction for SOSP?
No, we, let's see. If you look at this calculation,
you don't use the SQM. You don't use quantum mechanics, right?
Well, let's see. We do. Let's see. To the bubbling, we do have path into.
Yeah, but how did you evaluate the bubbling contribution?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so we have bubbling contribution at, let's see. So we learned from your guys' paper, and then.
Yeah, but I suspect you're.
No, your SDRT
checks, your SDRT check is for minuscule representations.
No, we did I just.
At least that's what the title says. For SOSP. I mean, yeah, I'm looking at the table of contents, and it says SDRT check for SOSP is for minuscule representation. So there are no multiple bubbling effects.
Monopole SDRT check for, right, so monopole bubbling means your charge has to be bigger than one, right? Not
just that. Minuscule means there is no bubbling effect.
But for example, page 21, we did bubbling.
Okay, I mean, I think
this is not a part place to argue about what.
Okay, you guys share credit peacefully. Yes, later. Yeah, yeah. any questions from the audience? Ami has a question.
Yeah, so how much of this work can be extended to six dimensions?
Six dimensional case. So, word volume theory, naively word volume theory, you mean the codimension three. Monopole bubbling effect in the co-dimension three object in six dimensional space.
Yes.
So if we take the plane configuration.
So if you think about the small instanton transition, this would be a case where you will have a contribution from the affine E8 diagram.
So now I don't know how to take a TDR in this picture. So five-dimensional SV take a TDR along a fixed direction. But six-dimensional SV do not know the direction along which we take the TDR.
Let's see.
Yeah, so sorry, I don't know.
I see.
Okay. Unfortunately, I'm in Beijing and they need to catch a train to Shanghai from now. So let's thank the Yutaka again for a wonderful talk. And hopefully you guys share the credit with Kimin peacefully.
Okay. Yeah. We'll discuss in email.
Yeah.
We are friends. Okay.
Friends. Of course. Anyway, yeah. I'm really interested in you guys' work. It's a great work.
Yeah, so actually I need to run from now. So yeah, thank you very much for the talk.
Thank you for the invitation.
Yeah.
Thank you.
It would be nice if you can send the slides to me and I can put it on with me.
Yeah, okay. Send the slide.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, thank you very much. I need to go. Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for coming.